ओके
ओके सो आई थिंक वेयर वर यू बिफोर
नो फॉर आवर डिलीवरी ऑफ गुड्स मैम
नो सर आई डोंट थिंक ही सॉ द रिसीप्ट ऑफ गुड्स
नो टिल कैंसिलेशन ऑफ पीओ इज देयर दुरई टिल कैंसिलेशन ऑफ पीओ यू आर देयर नो
हेलो मैम प्रीवियसली मैम for cancellation of PO
increase in PO okay
increase in PO
in you are an increase in PO
yes,
oh. okay
from there you need
okay fine yeah okay so here as you see okay
ma'am
see,
you started recording okay.
Yes sir it's recording so yeah see after the PO is approved okay it is likely that the PO quantities or the price amounts may be changed so in this example it is increased to 2 rupees 500 okay that is from 3000 it has increased by 500 rupees okay so then okay. A PO revision is created in such a situation all right okay. So the user usually updates the PO okay and creates a new version to change the amount okay and the user submits a PO revision for approval and the approver approves the document and this is how the accounting entries are posted so the budget it is budget accounting from PO distribution which is for debit to 500 which is 500 rupees and to reserve for encumbrance which is the obligation stage remember the PO is the obligation all right
okay
so this is the scenario which accounting entries which happen in the increase in the amount of a PO then in this situation there is a decrease in the price okay which is you've decreased it by 500 rupees okay so the encumbrance type is obligation the balance type is encumbrance and the journal entry you will again the as I said the user would update the PO and create another new revision to change the amount then the PO again submits for approval the approver approves it approves the document and this accounting entry is made reserve for encumbrance obligation debit 500 to budget account from PO distribution all right
okay
so this was in the case of decrease now even a cancellation also can happen okay in your day to day businesses so here the cancellation okay see in the original example assuming that the PO is cancelled for rupees 1800 okay so these are the following journal entry which is been made which is the reserve for encumbrance which is the obligation debit rupees 1800 to budget account from PO distribution rupees 1800 okay so okay these all things happen now after all this happens you have the receipt of goods and the services wherein you are receiving the goods right
okay
so here what happens is the accounting takes place okay at the time of receipt okay and the encumbrances are liquidated I mean as you know the encumbrances have to be liquidated because otherwise the balances will not match in your trial balance and your financial statements okay so the following this is the actual accounting impact so now here if you see in the previous examples that was still in the encumbrance stage but now here you are receiving the goods you are you'll be finally paying for the purchase order that you had created and you have to match your the invoice which the supplier gives against your budget okay so here the balance type would be your the actual and the journal entry date would be the receipt date of your goods and services that you will be receiving and the entry would be receiving inspection account debit rupees 3000 to AP that is your accrual liability account okay 3000 rupees okay so this is what happens in your receipt of goods and services then you move to the delivery of goods okay so when goods are delivered to the respective location these entries are created like again the balance type is actual date of delivery of your goods the entry would be charge account from PO distribution to rupees 3000 receiving inspection account charge account from PO distribution debit rupees 3000 to receiving inspection account rupees 3000 okay and here you have to reverse your because you have to set off the encumbrance account right otherwise the balances in your GL will mismatch
yes, sir.
So you will be setting off this so reserve for encumbrance obligation debit to rupees 3000 to budget account on PO distribution now if you see here in the purchase order, the entry is like this. See, budget account from PO distribution rupees 3000 and reserve for encumbrance is 3000. Now here, this becomes, you have to set it off. This, you reverse it. See here, you got the difference in the delivery of goods, reserve for encumbrance. You got the point, right? That entry in the purchase order that you make, that gets reserved, okay, during this stage. Okay, so that gets set off. Okay, that gets knocked off. And here next comes the invoice match PO, okay, the purchase order. So the user receives the invoice from the vendor for rupees 3000 and enters into the invoice details in the AP, Oracle Accounts Payables. Then a draft invoice is created. Okay, then the user matches the invoice with the PO shipment. The user then does the invoice accounting for the invoice. So these are the accounting entries which he makes. Okay, this is a journal entry date, which will be the GL date specified on the invoice distribution. So your AP accrual liability account, rupees 3000, to your supplier liability payables account. Okay, 3000 rupees. Now again, your thing has to get, the encumbrance has to, you know, reverse here. Okay, it's the same entry actually. I just put it here. It's an obligation reversal, which is your obligation is your PO level, right? But now you have, you're matching your invoice to your PO. So it will be reserved for encumbrance, obligation debit rupees 3000 to your budget account from PO distribution. Okay. Then finally is your payment. Here, even this account, your accrual also will get set off here. If you see, this is AP accrual over here. No, one second.
Invoice match.
Yeah, here, see, in your receipt of goods, receiving inspection account 3000 to AP accrual 3000, this account will get reversed here in the, in the invoice, when you're matching your invoice to your purchase order, see here, that AP accrual liability will get set off here, okay? Then AP accrual debit rupees 3000 to supply liability payables account, which is 3000. And finally comes your invoice payment stage, where, you know, you make a payment against the invoice which was sent by the supplier. So this is your actual entry which gets posted to your GL, okay? Which is a supplier liability rupees 3000 to your bank account rupees 3000. So this whole process is your P2P life cycle which happens, and this is how the encumbrance accounting happens. Now here, if you see the same example of that 2000, 10,000 budget that I gave. So finally, in your, your instance, you will get, not exactly like this, but I'm just explaining it to you. Okay. All these transactions happen. As I mentioned, the PO value, suppose, you know, you change your PO value from 3000 to 3500, it goes into your obligation as 3500, and you match your invoice to your PO for the payment, which is the actual expenditure 3500, and you're left with rupees 16500 in your budget account. That is your appropriation account.
It's called unencumbered.
Yes sir. I forgot to mention that this is called as unencumbered. So you're left with this amount in your encumbrance reserve. So this is how the whole process works. So basically, in a nutshell, if I want to say, budgetary control and encumbrance accounting is a complete and an integrated solution, okay, where it helps the organization to stay informed and in control. It also improves the insight and helps the company make better decisions. And it also helps in increase in productivity and efficiency. Okay, so this is what it is. So, any doubts here, Dore?
No, ma'am.
Sir, that's it for today, sir. Finished. Yeah.
Dore, you got clarity, no?
Yes, sir.
Very clear, no?
Yes, sir.
Accounting entries.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you're basically now you're aware of what encumbrance is. Okay.
Encumbrance.
And you know the difference between a budget and an encumbrance. Yes. Okay, that's good. So if you have, please go through those entries, the example that I've given in the Excel sheet, which I'll be sharing in some time. If you have any doubts, please do let me know. Okay, so that I can clarify it in tomorrow's class. Yes, sir. Sir, anything else?
No, ma'am. It's clear only. Dore, you so you are comfortable, no, with the what is encumbrance and what encumbrance. Is budget. Yeah. So the accounting entries also the man showed, no, it's very clear, no,
yes,
with live
yes,
examples, with amount and all.
Yes,
okay. So now, so, see, this is a same P2P cycle, which madam will take on Monday also, okay?
Yes, we'll be starting with accounts payable, okay, from Monday.
Okay.
Should be able to finish GL this week. We'll start with accounts payable. So I'll again, you know, walk you through the whole P2P cycle. But this was just an example of how encumbrance happens in a P2P cycle.
Okay.
So that you just get a, you know, better understanding before I actually get into the P2P cycle. That's the reason I chose this example. Okay. So, but as you are working in a accounts payable department, you must be aware of P2P, you know, in a, you know, in a practical way, right? Okay. So you'll be able to relate with whatever, you know, we are teaching. Good, that's good, okay, sir, I think that's for today. Is there anything else? I think we can end for the day, sir, for today's class.
Yeah, sure, we can end.
Okay, fine.
Thank you, Durai.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay.